effect of despreading of a narrow band interference. Interference is nothing but a noise only. That is a jamming signal. Suppose if an RF, that is a received signal, we will get with then that is AC into cos 2 pi FC of the carrier with B of the information signal and the carrier sequence plus we will get an interference, that is I of T. Suppose if the effect of despreading, suppose if an add and information added with an interference, where that is I of T denotes the interference, the despreading operation at the receiver yields here R of T into C of T we will get. That is, if we multiply this signal with the local PN sequences C of T, we will get AC into B of T. AC B of T into cos 2 pi FCT plus I of T into C of T, where the bandwidth spreads to the W hertz. And the example I of T is equals to AI into cos FI of T. Here FI is nothing but the frequency within the bandwidth of a transmitted signal. Multiplication with the carrier signal results in a wide band interference with the power spectral density. We can given by an I naught is equals to PI by W, where PI is equals to A square I by 2. This is since the desired signal is demodulated by a matched filter or a correlation that has a bandwidth of an R, and the total power of an interference of the output of a demodulator is given by IO into RB is equals to PI by W into RB is equals to PT by W by RB, where if we go and that is PI is equals to, we know that W by RB is equals to TB by TC, that is called as an PI by LC, where the factor W by R is equals to TB by TC is equals to LC is called as a processing gain. If you want to calculate the processing gain, the problems and all, we can calculate the processing gain. For that, we will use the TB by TC of the spread spectrum signal. And coming to next topic, that is a SNR processing gain and the jamming margin. We know already, we studied that is PG processing gain is nothing but a TB by TC, or we can write it as a WC by RB, where RB and WB are the baseband parameters. When RB is equals to 1 by TB and WC is equals to 1 by TC, the output signal to noise ratio is defined in the instantaneous peak power. EB is divided by the variance of the equivalent noise component. Thus SNR is given by 2 into EB by JTC, where JTC by 2 is the variance of a random noise representing the this is a jammer. J is a jammer, and the input noise ratio is defined by an SNR. I is equals to EB by TB by J. EB by TB by J. Hence, the output of an SNR is given by 2 into, both in the ratio we will written as a 2 into TB by TC into SNR into I. SNR, that is the input SNR ratio I. Therefore, in the decibel, we can write it as a 10 log 10 base 10. SNR output is equals to 10 base 10 SNR I plus 3 plus 10 log 10 PG in terms of decibels, where and the jamming margin can be defined as in ratio of the average interference power PJ to signal power P, that is JM is equals to G by P. And coming to an anti-jam characteristics, jam characteristics, the probability of an spreading the signal, P is given by 1 by 2 ERC into square root of EB by JTC. And finally, we will get a jamming margin is equals to PG by EB by E naught. For in calculating, we will get a, for this is a formula, that is jamming margin. DB is equals to processing gain DB minus 10 log 10 EB by N naught into D N naught. It's in the value decibel. Next is the pseudo random, pseudo noise P sequences, that is P PN sequences. PN sequences is defined as in coded sequences of the ones and zeros with certain autocorrelation properties, that is it has certain within autocorrelation properties, and these sequences are periodic, and these signals are periodic. And the most widely used binary PN sequence PN code sequences are maximum of an maximum length shift register sequences. We are using in shift register sequences, and the maximum length shift register sequences or the M sequence of a short of as a length of, that is L is equals to 2 power M minus 1 bit, and it is generated by a M stage of shift register. We are using the shift register with the linear feedback as shown in the figure I show. The sequence are in the these sequences are periodic with an L, and each period consists of a 2 power m minus 1, that is L is it contain each period, that is the sequence whatever we are getting, it has a 2 to the power of m minus 1 ones and 2 power m minus 1 of zeros, that is ones and zeros. Consider here is an 3-stage shift register, that is x1, x2, x3 are 3 shift registers, and the output of an x2 and x3 are added with then modulo 2, that is x1 dash, and that is x2 plus or plus xor plus x3. We will get back to the information about with the input again to the x1 only. Initially, this is the acts as a modulo xor operation. It works in the shift register works with an xor operation. Okay, and next consider here, since there is a we are using a 3 shift register stages, and since each stages as a either of a ones and zeros, this can be as a 2 power m whatever, this is a 3 shift register, so 2 power 3 is equals to 8 a distinct of set of the contents, that is including 0. Okay, and here 0 is not however the 000 state is not permitted, because once the shift register contents are 0, there will be no change whatever it may be the number of shifts or if we apply the clocking signal also, that is there is no change because 0 into 0 is 0 only. Consider here the clock pulses are initially 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this is the present stage. Present stage, this is nothing but a x1, x2, x3. These are the 3 shift registers, that is x1, x2, x3 are the 3 shift registers. Initially, it has an contents is a 1, 1, 1. So, initially, it has a 1, 1, 1. That is the present stage is x1, x2, x3 as a 1, 1, 1. That is it is shown here. That is we will get an operation of x2 plus x3, x2 and x1 will be 1, 1, 1. This 1, 1, 1 it will be written here. And for the next stage, we will get an XOR operation, that is x2 with x3, that is 1 plus 1 is in the XOR, 1 1 is 0 only, so 0, 1 plus 1 0, and again these 2 bits are shifted here, that is x1 and x2 shifted here. And for the next also we will get what is the year 0, 1 1 1, this value written here, and for this value again 1 1 is 0 only, so 0 again this value is shifted here, so 111, and next this 001 is written here, 001 01 is 1 only, so 1 this value is shifted here, 00, and this written here, then 00 is nothing but an 0 only, so 0, the value x2 before it is considered, this is an x1 only, no, because for an x1 we will get an operation about the x2 plus or minus x2 plus x3, that is x2 XOR with x3, we can call, write it as an x1 also. Therefore this x1 value will be shifted here, just it is shifted here, and again this state will be written in here like this. Up to how we will do is this, look at here 1110, and again if we shifted 01 means 10 means 1 only, so 111, though it is same as the first stage, so it repeated, it's a periodic signal, it's repeated, so until this we have to do, after this we should stop looking for an state diagram of an three stage state diagram of a three stage linear feedback shift register. 000 essentially, if we shift register also, if we as a shifted how many times we can shift also, the answer will be 00 only. Coming here, look at the sequences are written here, that is 111 011 00 1 100 010 101 110, like this. These values are written here in the state diagram. Okay, thus the PN sequence generator produces a sequence of an length L, and these as the these after the same sequences will be separated, and this will be expected since in the excluded one pattern, that is all pattern consists of 000. If then if n is the length of a sequence and m is the number of shift register, here n is equals to 2 to the power of m minus 1, where here 2 power m is nothing but a PN sequences with 2 power m minus 1 is the length called the maximum length sequence. We can tell it as a MLS, that is it has a PN sequences length as a maximum length sequences, that is ML sequences having of a many properties possessed by a truly random binary sequence, a binary sequence of an 1 and 0 or equiprobably. There are three properties of an ML sequences, that is the maximum length sequences. First is the balance property, and next is the run property. Next is the run property, and next is the autocorrelation property. Where in the consider the balance property, in each period of an ML sequence, the number of ones is always one more than the number of zeros. Here I told balance properties, in each period of an ML sequence, the number of ones is always more than the number of zeros. Consider here one sequence, that is PN sequences. Look at here, this is a sequence, that is 00100011100 010111. Here we need to check the how many number of ones are there. Ones is nothing but a ones, how many? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, okay, 7 of number of zeros here, sorry, number of zeros 7, and number of ones we need to check, that is ones is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Here number of zeros is 7 and number of ones is 8, that is in the each period I told the number of ones is always one more than the number of zeros, that is zeros is always one more than the number of zeros. And next is the run length property, where here the period is such the 2 power n minus 1 bits, the number of ones is equals to number of ones is 2 power n minus 1, and the number of zeros is nothing but the 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. Consider for an n is equals to 3, the period will be 2 power 3 minus 1 is equals to, that is 2 power 3 is 8, 8 minus 1 is 7, and number of 1s is 2 power 3 minus 1 is equals to 2 power of 3 minus 1 is 2 is equals to 4, and the number of zeros is equals to 2 power 3 minus 1 minus 1, that is 2 power 3 minus 1 is nothing but 4. 4 minus 1 is the answer 3. So like that, that is 1s and the 0 should be more, and the 1 in a 0 jaasti irbeku, 0 id madre 1 jaasti irbeku. And next is the run property. Here run is a subsequent of an identical symbols of an appearance of the alternate digit in a sequence starts a new run among the number of ones and zeros in each period of an ml sequence. That is, consider one example here. Consider here in the run length ones and zeros in each period of an ml sequence, that is maximum length sequence. 1 of is equals to, that is 50% of a runs are the length of 1 and 25% of a length of n 2 and 12.5, that is 1 half, 1 fourth and 1 eighth of n length of n 3 and so on. Consider here this is an ml, that is maximum length sequence. It has a that is in the period PN sequences only. Here we need to check, that is how many runs are there, that is number of zeros and ones grouping method, that is 3 zeros we can call it as a one group, and 1 0 we can call it as in one group, and 2 zeros we can call it as in one group, 1 1 0 one group, next 0 1 group, 1 1 group, 0 1 group, then 4 ones we can call it as a one group. That is consider really number of lengths are length 1, that is total run next length runs is 1 2 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, that is runs is equals to number of runs is 8 here. And next in that we need to check the number of 50% of the runs are the length 1. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಿದೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಒನ್ ಒನ್ ಇರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಒನ್ ಟೂ ಒನ್ ಟೂ ತ್ರೀ ಫೋರ್, ಇದು ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರೀ ಒನ್, ಈಗ ಒನ್ ಅದು ಬರೀ ಒಂದೇ ಇದೆ, ಒನ್ ಟೂ ತ್ರೀ ಫೋರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 8 ಇದೆ, ಟೋಟಲ್ 8 ಇದೆ. ಈ 8ಲ್ಲಿ 50% ಅಂತಂದರೆ 4, ಟೋಟಲ್ ಬಂದು 100% ಅಂದರೆ 8, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 50% ಅಂತಂದರೆ 4, 4 ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 4 ಇದೆಯಾ, 1 2 3 4, that is 50% of the length are the 1, first condition here length satisfied. Next 25% of the length of n 2, that is 1/4 iradane ide adrudina kal bhagadashtu length 2 values irbeku, 2 value ga 2 2 value iradidya, 1 2 in 2 zeros 1 value, 2 2 ones 1 value, that is 2, idon sequence aitu idon sequence aitu. So 25% of the length 2 ಇರೋದು 2 ಇದೆಯಾ, ಓಕೆ ಅದು ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್ 50% 4 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 25% 2 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 12.5% 3 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, 12 ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 001 ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 11 ಬರೀ 0001 ಒನ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್, ಸೊ 3 ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಸೊ 8/3 ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು 3. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎನ್ ಆಟೋ ಕೋರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆಟೋ ಕೋರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ದಿ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಎಮ್ ಎಲ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪೀರಿಯಾಡಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಬೈನರಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆಟೋ ಕೋರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಸ್ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಕೆ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು 1/n ಇಂಟು summation n varies from 1 to n cn of n into cn of n minus k, where here n is equals to length or the period of the sequence and k is the lag of an autocorrelation sequence. K is the autocorrelation sequence for an ml sequence of a length l, and the autocorrelation sequence is a periodic with the period n, and two values are shown here, that is k is equals to ln is the value, then the autocorrelation value is 1. If k is not equal to ln, then the value will be minus of 1/n. Consider here one example. Consider here one example, that is in 0 0 0 consider this is one sequence, that is 00101010101. Here, in this, the output of a shift register is 1 bit shift here. That is, this signal will be shifted here. That is, the 1 is shifted here, and next all bits are shifted by this only. Then 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 1 1, and after this we need to calculate the number of agreements and the number of disagreements. Here same ittu antandre we can call it as a agreements, and different ittu antandre we can call it as a disagreements. That is d 0 1 0 is a idli id madidre 0 0 is 0 1 adre ಅದು ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. 00 ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಸೇಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಇದು ಇದು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇದು ಇದು ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಸೇಮ್ ಇದೆ, ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ 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 agreement agreement agreement. That is check where is to check whether the values will be same or changed, and after that that is RK of n, that is autocorrelation of an n sequence is given by 1 by n into how many number of agreements. Agreements minus number of disagreements, that is 1 by n. Here we need to calculate number of A's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is 7. Then number of disagreement, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. That is 1 by n is nothing but a total, we will get a sequence as a, that is so total sequence is 15, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 50. So 50 minus 1, therefore minus 1 by 15. So when k is not equal to ln, the value will be minus 1 by n, where l is an any integer.